Well, first of all, I'd like to really thank everyone for their time coming to hear us speak. And obviously, thank you also to all the amazing Pathways organisers for this opportunity. Okay, so I'll transition to the next slide, and Tali is going to do the acknowledgement of country.
Before we begin, I would like to make an acknowledgement of country. We acknowledge the tradition of custodianship and the land of country on which we are meeting today. We are joining the meeting from the land of the Bidjigal and Gadigal people of the Eora Nation. We pay our respects to those who have cared and continue to care for us, care for these countries.
Thanks, Tali, and I'll just transition to the next slide. Great, so to say a little bit more about who we are and where we're from. So the Centre for Disability Studies is a non-profit organisation affiliated with the University of Sydney. We've been in operation since 1997, and the Year to Beyond program we're talking about has been running for about 10 years. So, and to introduce the both of us, so Tali Hine, yes, as Carolyn said, is an alumna of the program, and I am the Uni to Beyond career advisor. Great, so just want to start by doing a little overview of what we're going to be talking about this afternoon. So on to the next slide. So firstly, just a bit of an overview of what Uni to Beyond is, because it's a fairly unique program. Secondly, a little bit about intellectual disability and employment, as that's a major focus for us. Next, about how the program supports our students to find meaningful careers. And then lastly, we'll speak specifically about our internship program. And I'll just transition to the next slide. So currently in Australia, the inclusion of people with intellectual disability into mainstream and secondary schooling, primary and secondary schooling, is becoming more common. However, the transition into tertiary level education is a new frontier. Likewise, many workplaces remain closed to the inclusion of people with intellectual disability. So Uni to Beyond exists to break down the barriers for people with intellectual disability who want to experience university life and employment. So to introduce the initiative in a bit more detail, we'd like to show you a short video. So I'd like to note here that this video includes Tali, which is wonderful, and also our previous director, Patricia O'Brien, who recently retired. Great. So I'm also going to put a YouTube link in the chat for this, because I know that if there's any troubles with streaming, great.
I think what makes it unique is that it is enabling students with intellectual disability to gain a post-secondary education. Here at Sydney University, Uni to Beyond gives the students the opportunity to choose whatever subjects they have great interest in, and they audit those subjects over a period of 2 years. Students with intellectual disability going to university was the next frontier.
When I heard about the Uni to Beyond program, I said, yes, I would like to do it.
I just love being able to be like a regular student, coming to uni, socializing with people, getting to know people, learning things that I wouldn't ordinarily get to learn.
When I was first approached to have someone in my class from Uni to Beyond, I was like, absolutely, without a doubt, this is the program that I am inspired to be a part of. To have someone with a disability in my classroom participating as a regular student, I was on board.
When I was first approached by Uni to Beyond, I had a bit of trepidation. I wasn't sure that I had enough training to help them and teach them effectively, because I was worried that the Uni to Beyond students wouldn't integrate well with the other students in the classroom. My fears were totally baseless. They integrated well. The other students made them feel welcome. They helped them out on the task, and they didn't treat them like they were different. It was beautiful to watch. And I see they're eager, they're bright, they're enthused, they really want to get involved, so their capability is large.
Time and time again, I see inclusion as a major, major thing that's improving and making a huge impact on the lives of people with a disability.
As a university student, they have two mentors. One is an academic mentor and one is a social mentor.
Throughout the semester, they just become friends and they're like your friends for life.
From my perspective, I see them having a chance to engage with other students. They learn the structure, coming to university, finding a table to sit in the tutorials, interacting with other students. Everything has its challenge.
I always was excited for uni even though I had no idea what to expect. Starting uni took some getting used to, but it has become the most fun learning experience so far. My favorite part of being a uni student is just being on campus and having the freedom to do what I want at uni, getting lunch and hanging out with friends in my classes.
By introducing internships, our students can have a taster of what they might like to do in terms of employment. So we talk with them and find out what's an area that they would like to work in, and then we match them with a placement, you know, whether it's in commerce or whether it's in industry or retail, so that they can have an opportunity to see if this is what they want to pursue in the future.
I am proud of the work that we've been doing, and I hope to be involved in this program as long as I work at the university.
So I think in terms of the Uni to Beyond program, it's really kind of advancing how we see disability and breaking down a lot of those barriers. And that can have such an impact on the individual and then also on the university culture as we embrace diversity and inclusion, which is just such an important part of life here.
Well, the students grow in confidence, they grow in their own self-esteem, they stand a mile higher than they did before they came, they network with other university students, and they no longer feel different.
Great, so I've just transitioned to the next slide there. Hopefully that video worked well for everyone, but like I said, I'll make sure I put the YouTube link in the chat. And now maybe Taylor, you could tell us a bit more about what it was like to be a Uni to Beyond student.
Okay, hi everyone, I'm Taylor. I was in the presentation. So yeah, I really love Uni to Beyond. I did it, so it's a 2-year initiative and students can choose subject of interest on their own interest. So it's not their parents, it's really what you want to do. So for me, I did some health, I did some music, I did creative arts, and I just really enjoyed being on campus, being able to learn, feeling like I was part of the general society, and just really enjoying it. So we do need to be on, we don't have to do the big assessments and assignments and tests and exams that normal uni students do, but we do see an academic mentor once a week or once a fortnight who pretty much breaks down the barriers, breaks down each unit of each subject that each individual does, and would go through, say for example, I was studying health and we were looking at water. So one student, for example, might have to write a 1-page report, where someone else could just have to get 10 pictures. So it's really specified to each individual. So that's what I really loved about it. Everyone can show what they're capable of, and there's not really any boundaries of who can and who can't do it, because everyone is working on their own and achieving their own goals and working on their own units, really.
Wonderful. Thank you, Taylor. Appreciate you sharing that. And so, as I'm sure you can all imagine, things have changed a little bit in the COVID environment. So for semester one, everything was entirely online. And then semester two, we did have some students returning to a little bit of in-person study. But it's certainly been challenging, but I really think that all our students have sort of risen to the challenge and made the most of what I think has been a really difficult year study-wise. And then generally in terms of the Uni to Beyond program, we're also looking at expanding the model, possibly within Australia or overseas. So it's something that we're really excited about for the future. So I've talked a bit about Uni to Beyond and the university side as a response to the need to include people with intellectual disability in Australian universities. And now we'd like to turn to look at the inclusion of people with intellectual disability in Australian workplaces. So I'll transition to the next slide. So in 2018, 38.9% of working age people with intellectual disability were in the labour force, compared with 53.4% of people with other types of disability and 84.1% of people without disability. So as you can see, there's a heightened impact beyond that of other people with disability for people with intellectual disability in the world of work. To think about what these statistics really mean, you know, we would say that they represent a loss for people with intellectual disability who want meaningful careers, a loss for employers of potentially of valuable employees, and a loss for society of the working contribution and diversity that people with intellectual disability could bring to work. So, which is why we, in the last few years, have added a career advisory service to the Uni to Beyond program to facilitate these transitions. And so this service is available both for our current students and for our alumni students. Moving to the next slide. So just a little bit about what kind of support we provide for students. So for our current students and for alumni, we do things like assisting them to find jobs, undertake internships, which we'll talk a little bit more about in a minute, to connect with employment services like DES providers, to learn new work skills, and in some cases to find further study. So Charlie, maybe you could talk a little bit about the work you've done with the Career Advisory Service at Uni to Beyond.
Yes, the Career Advisor at Uni to Beyond has really helped me just really finding a DES provider, and then while I was looking for a DES provider, helping me look at other options, where what I could do in the interim before I get a job. So looking through TAFE courses, looking at TAFE courses online, trying to approach different companies, and just really be there as like a backbone for someone with an intellectual disability who may be a bit lost or may find it a bit challenging and just needs a bit more support, where their parent or carer may not be able to provide that. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you, Tali. Appreciate hearing about your experience. And so we want to go into a little bit more depth specifically about our internship program. So I'll go to the next slide. Here we are. Okay, so Uni to Beyond students have the opportunity to undertake paid internships to explore possible career aspirations. So we've partnered with a diverse range of institutions to host Uni to Beyond interns, including major banks, city councils, engineering firms, cultural institutions, and our own university, the University of Sydney. In fact, we currently have an internship in progress at KPMG Australia. So, Tali, you were a Uni to Beyond intern. Would you be happy to tell us a bit more about your internship experience?
Yeah, sure. So I did mine at KPMG, which you can see, that's not me on the screen, but I did it at the same company. So it was 2 days a week for 6 weeks, and I did various tasks from putting the Christmas party function together, looking for a venue, looking for fun games, tidying up the office, doing filing, stationery orders, data entry, decorating the office for Christmas, organising a Christmas lunch for the staff in the office that I was working in. So just really whatever needed to be done, I was just like a helping hand, just an extra pair of hands to help.
Wonderful. Thank you, Tali. And if you wanted to, you could talk a little bit more about your work since then.
Okay. So since Uni to Beyond, I have got a current casual job at a community centre in Willara at the Holworth Community Centre, but I'm still looking for a permanent part-time office admin role. But in the interim, I have done some TAFE courses. So last year I did a retail course at Ultimo Chase in New South Wales, which where we are based for anyone outside of New South Wales. That's like in the heart of the city. And then this year, because of COVID, I'm still looking for a job, but it's been a bit challenging. So I decided to do an online online TAFE course. So this year I did a intermediate Excel course, which I really, really thoroughly enjoyed. And I think for me, it was just proving to myself that I could study online. I never thought I could do it, but I actually got through it. I've completed the course and I've got my statement of attainment. So yeah, go me.
Thank you, Tali. That's, yeah, wonderful. Thank you. So I think we've come pretty much to the end of our time. I just wanted to offer, if anyone wants any further information, I'm quite happy to provide a summary or an easy read summary of the information we've talked about today. And I also really want to thank Tali for coming to speak and being such a great advocate for the program. I was hoping we'd have some time for questions. I wanted to just quickly acknowledge Susan Beard's comment that absolutely the Up the Hill program at Flinders is amazing, and we're developing our links with them and they do great work. So, and lastly, I'll just quickly put my email in the chat box. So I'm quite happy to be contacted if anyone has follow-up questions.